Shamik, I believe you wrote in your journal when you were about 14 years old that you would one day be Spider-Man.
I wrote it in my journal while filming the movie Dope. I was probably 18 when that happened. I'm 23 now.
Yeah, I started writing my thoughts, and on one of the pages, I'm like, I am Miles Morales. I turn it over, I am Spider-Man. This is one of many things that's in that journal, but 2 years later,
here you are.
Yeah. My name is Miles Morales, and in my world, I'm the one and only Spider-Man. That is, until he showed up.
Jake, you probably thought that your days of playing a superhero were over. When you got the script for Peter Parker, what did you think?
Well, I never got a script for it. I got an email from Phil Lord about it. And, you know, I was excited about it. I think it's a great project.
Can you have too many spider people, or would that be an infestation?
Well, we're gonna find out.
we found what we think is the right balance for this movie, because at the end of the day, it's a coming-of-age story about Miles Morales, his family, and him finding a new group of friends and finding out he's not alone.
How many more spider people are there?
Hey, fellas.
Hello.
This could literally not get any weirder.
It can get weirder.
We think we found a nice balance where there are enough to give them the idea that, you know, there's many different versions of people and anyone really can be behind the mask, but not so much that it takes away from his story.
Did you think about asking John Hamm to play Spider-Man?
It was discussed.
It was discussed. he is too elegant.
Yes, I mean, he's
and
a really,
handsome.
He's very a funny and charming dude. But then when somebody played for us a clip of John Mulaney's voice, we were like, well, that's Spider-Ham. There's no one else can be it.
My name is Peter Porker. Do animals talk in this dimension? Because I don't want to freak him out.